come on.
Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that may be. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex.
Hello, and welcome to another edition of The Author's Attic, a production of the journal Social Problems, the official journal for the Society for the Study of Social Problems. I'm Trenton Haltom, and today we are joined by Professor Eric Anthony Grollman of the University of Richmond, whose article, Sexual Health and Multiple Forms of Discrimination Among Heterosexual Youth, is now featured in Social Problems. This article speaks to the racial, ethnic, gender, and social class disparities in sexual behaviors of adolescents. To learn more, let's hear from Professor Grollman.
In this paper, I wanted to address the problem of high sexually transmitted infection rates, or STIs, unintended pregnancy, and teen pregnancy, particularly among adolescents and young adults in the U.S. And I'm especially concerned with the disparities in these outcomes along the lines of race and ethnicity, gender, and social class. It's been well documented from the Centers for Disease Control, CDC, as well as other research that Black and Latino youth, girls and young women, and poor working class youth have the highest rates of STIs, HIV/AIDS, unintended pregnancy, and teen pregnancy. So what we've done as a research community to try to figure out what's leading to these disparities is to focus on the behaviors. What are the behaviors and what are the differences in those behaviors that are leading to these disparities? So my study builds on this focus on inequality and sexual behaviors and sexual health by looking at interpersonal discrimination. So I wanted to know youth who experience some sort of unfair treatment because of their social class, their race, their ethnicity, their gender. I wanted to know, are these victims of discrimination more likely to experience negative outcomes of sexual activity? And so what that means is having to focus on the behaviors, whether or not discrimination is in turn making victims turn to risky sexual practices and then are developing these negative outcomes of sexual activity. And what we know from research on discrimination in physical health and research on discrimination in mental health is that there is indeed a link. By virtue of the sort of distressing nature of facing discrimination, one is sort of keyed up or in a sort of fight or flight mode. And when your body is revved up, the adrenaline is going, the pulse is up, the blood pressure is up. When that happens chronically, your health actually wears over time. It wears on your physical health. And that with the suppression of the immune system, as well as the greater likelihood of smoking, drinking, and abusing drugs, this is all setting the stage for victims of discrimination to have high rates of hypertension, of cancers, obesity, even premature death. And on the mental health side, the sort of undermining of one's self-worth sets the stage for people to develop mental illnesses, depression, anxiety, PTSD, panic disorders, and so forth. So I wanted to see, does this negative impact of discrimination also translate into sexual health consequences? So what I do in this study is I use data from the Black Youth Culture Survey, which was collected by the Black Youth Project under the supervision of political scientist Kathy J. Cohen, to see whether Black, Latino, and white youth ages 15 to 25 who face discrimination are more likely to engage in risky sexual practices, specifically early sexual debut or having sex before the age of 15, having multiple sexual partners, inconsistently using condoms, and inconsistently using contraception. What I find in this study is that the more discrimination youth face, the more likely that they were to have sex before the age of 15 and to have multiple sexual partners. I did not find, however, that discrimination was linked with inconsistent condom and contraceptive use. So while youth may be having more sexual partners and having sex at an earlier age when they're facing discrimination, it does not seem to be influencing their condom use and their contraceptive use. And so it comes as a little surprise that discrimination actually was not linked with STIs, with abortion and with teen pregnancy. So this is, in some ways, good news and bad news that there is some degree of connection between discrimination and youth sexual behaviors. However, the good news is that even though youth may be turning to sexual activity, maybe to alleviate the stress of discrimination or to feel pleasure or what have you, reasons that actually have been cited for youth having sex, we at least can be assured in that it does not appear to be affecting their strategies to protect themselves from pregnancy and STIs. What I would take from this study is, one, a major problematization of this term at risk, this focus on risk. So what scholars tend to do is conflate any sexual activity in youth with risk. And in fact, there were some behaviors. So youth are turning to, they are potentially turning to youth, excuse me, they're turning to sexual activity early and with multiple partners, but they're protecting themselves. And so the question is, are they really at risk? At risk for what? Because discrimination was not linked with STIs, abortion, or teen pregnancy. And I would go a step further to say that we really should problematize the labeling of entire communities, particularly marginalized youth, as at risk. When we're focusing just on their behaviors and not looking at their social circumstances, it's very easy to fall into the trap of labeling a person as at risk instead of looking at the behaviors. But as I just said a moment ago, even the behaviors themselves should not be automatically labeled as risky, because youth may also be taking an approach that is sort of mindful of the risk, but they are also weighing the risk. They're using a condom every time they have sex with a new partner. They're using contraceptives to prevent pregnancy.
Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex.